Hey guys, welcome back to Dungeon Defenders. Here we are at the Magus Quarters. I remember my first playthrough of this game. This was the first level to give me a very real degree of difficulty. It was not pretty. I grew to know this level very well through repeated practice. Fortunately, that practice was not for naught. I did learn this level very well. I learned all of the choke points, all the weak points, all the stronger points. I learned that wyverns are a pain in the ass. And of course, I learned that sometimes a good slice and dice blockade can be a good deterrent, and sometimes it's just not enough. So with that in mind, I'm gonna have to really think through how to start out here. I think for now I'm gonna do this. Put one of these on each side. And I'm going to focus my attacking power on the other side over there. Now, my first playthrough, I made the mistake of severely underestimating the usefulness of the bowling ball turret. Believe it or not, it does have its uses. And it does have its advantages over the crossbow turret. And of course it has its disadvantages. But it has some very unexpected advantages as well. Alright, you. Stop that. For one thing, it does have a lot of knockback, and also it has a very large range compared to, the frontal range, or however you want to call it, is very large compared to the crossbow. The crossbow has a good, side-to-side range. But this one will, for tight corridors like this, it's a good choice. And I forgot I didn't have any defenses over here. I may have screwed myself from the get-go here. Where am I? Very hard to see. Just these guys left. He fell into the lava. The only thing that sucks about the lava is that it, any gems they drop go along with them into the lava. But I guess it's better than having your crystal compromised. And I do say that with a degree of reluctancy. But anyway, we've got some strategy to strategize. Alright, so the main points of entry are of course going to be these things here on all three sides. Thinking, should I spring for a slice and dice already? Perhaps that might be a good idea. So let's gather this up. And let's place another one of these bad boys. Gather ourselves some chests. Of course, the first attempt is always, you know, just to feel things out. See what the deal is gonna be. Now, when do those wyverns start coming in? Eventually, there's gonna be wyverns. And I don't like those guys. Those guys suck. Not a fan. But anyway, doesn't look like we're gonna have any this round. I don't know if I want to hang back and just observe how my defense is kind of fair on this. Doing fine so far, and he just fucked himself over, which I guess is fine. I guess he thought he was gonna try and juke my defenses, but he juked himself straight into the drink. The very hot drink, and I don't mean coffee. Very nice, looks like everything's making short work of these guys. Very happy about this, very happy. We only had that one archer left on that side. Wow. Oh. The wyverns will be a thing in this next round. I guess I'm gonna have to place some crossbows and then gauge whether I want to do some upgrading or some repairing. I'm gonna put a crossbow right here. This should take care of this wyvern and this wyvern. Over here, we'll be greeted with a second one. Crossbow. Just for you, Mr. Wyvern. Enjoy that. The abundance of lava in this level definitely makes things more precarious. Of course, you have to be careful about how you navigate, but you also have to be careful about how you collect your spoils of war, I call it. All these mana gems just strewn about the floor that gravitate towards you, and then if you fill up on mana, they will be slingshot further out, and potentially they will be disintegrated in a very hot ooze of molten rock. I could do this. I have one crossbow in the back facing the gem and sniping anybody that decides to be sneaky, namely probably the wyverns. Alright. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade this as well as its counterpart. Yeah, the one thing that kind of sucks about being the squire is you can't start taking out those wyverns on your own from a distance. You gotta just let them come towards you, hope your defenses at least take a chunk out of them, and then hope for the best. Whoa, hey. There we go. At least they seem to be taking a like to my defenses rather than going after the crystal. Well, I kinda helped there. Hey, Mr. Splody. I think we're doing all right. We'll go ahead and upgrade this. That slice and dice is taking kind of a beating. Maybe I'll upgrade it again because it's gonna have to happen eventually. Why, Mr. Archer? Why? Okay. You are thoroughly upgraded. Oh no. Okay, so it seems in the next round, we're gonna have two wyverns to contend with. Okay, I'm probably gonna have to focus my energy on them, so I should probably go ahead and make sure that these defenses are tip-top, so nothing ends up getting past. That slice and dice might meet its maker, that one in the center there. Little concerned about this particular area. But I mean, I'll be around, you know. If they end up getting past that slice and dice, I'll be right over here fending off wyverns. And they'll still have to get through the bowling ball. You know what? I think it might be prudent to place a bouncer blockade. If I can get it there. So that it's gonna bounce them straight into the lava. And there we go. If you weren't aware, the little arrows that were facing out of the blockade, that's where your enemies are going to be bounced. Well, that wyvern came out right away. Oh wow, short work. Holy crap, that is three wyverns. That's three wyverns. Oh crap. Die, wyvern. Die. Ah. It's a good thing I placed this back here. Oh well, the wyverns are dead. Hey. I just heard a kaboomy. Oh boy. I hate those kaboomies. But we seem to be doing just fine. Wow. This is what I like to call an unexpected pleasant outcome. Nice. Very nice. You go ahead and die. Ooh. Maybe I can go ahead and upgrade this. Ow. Give myself a little blockage. There we go. Now go ahead and die. There you go. Good archers. Very good archers. Oh, I almost fell into the lava. Okay. Let's prepare you. Hey. Stop that. Okay. Ow. I'll hear you. Okay. You die. Die. Okay, you're dead. I know there's someone around here. Of course it's an archer. And he is dispatched. And my defenses are almost dispatched. And so am I, holy crap. My health, though. Wow. Okay. Should I spend 400 mana upgrading this thing? I think that's a worthy investment. It has served us very well. Despite the fact that they don't have the precision of a crossbow defending that one tower there, they have the bowling ball, which is very rough, very, not very accurate at all. Just kinda falls where it may. And yet it has been suffice. It has sufficed in defending these slicing dice. And I rhymed. Wow, this is the final wave. I'm a little concerned. I've never reached the final wave this easily on this level. This level has always been a pain in the ass for me. Not sure how I feel about it just being easy. Maybe I could just do a simple blockade crossbow combo down here. That's going to be a lot of strain on those two slicing dices. Maybe I can do a bouncer blockade and a crossbow. These wyverns are going to be a problem, I think. But we will get to that when we get to it. So without further ado, let's get this started. There's two wyverns. Oh, straight into the lava with those gems. Well, at least I know my crossbows are doing good. Doing good work. This is the only slice and dice blockade that isn't fully upgraded. I think I might do that at some point during this wave. This is the final wave. I can't believe we got here this quickly. This level has always been such a pain in the butt. Ow. Go ahead and do that now. We've got four archers working on this. Uh-oh. That would be the wyverns. Can't see much. Eh. Okay, there go those wyverns. Alright, he's having a hard time with this. Very good. Alright, bouncer blockade got taken out. That's not a that's not a big deal. This, however, is a very big deal. Die, wyvern! Okay, let's heal up a little bit. Okay, oh no. There goes the ogre. Let's upgrade this right now. Ah, give me a friggin' second to upgrade my thing. Oh no. And there goes me. Holy crap. That was me falling into a pit of lava. This ogre has so much health. Holy crap. Holy crap. Let's gather some mana. And we gotta place a slice and dice, like, now. That's that. Crystal is dead. It had a sliver of health left after those wyverns. Wow. That went south very quickly.